Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and Android Q Beta 6 is now out for developers and beta testers, and this is the final beta before the public release. And the public release comes in Q3 according to Google, so we'll see that probably in late September. But this final beta brings with it finalized APIs as well as fixes and optimizations. Now in the notes, just so you're aware, users with accessibility needs may not want to use this. They said it may not be appropriate for daily use. So keep that in mind if you need accessibility features and you wanted to try this out, may not be a great idea. Now this particular version was not very large as far as the download goes. It's 264.3 megabytes. And if we take a look at the build number, it's QPP6190730.005. And that is on my Pixel 3 XL. Now there are a bunch of other supported devices. I'll run them down through here. But if your particular device is not on that list, then it's up to your manufacturer to support that. So you'll probably see Android Q in its finalized form sometime later on when they decide to actually adapt their device for that. Now we'll go over the changes. We'll also go over some of the known issues that Google has noted in the notes as well toward the end of the video. So the first thing is the Pixel Ambient display mode, when you use a Pixel stand, is a little bit different looking. Now I don't have a Pixel stand right here, but I do have a wireless charger and it's very similar now. So if you put this on a charger, you'll see you have your time, you have your date, your weather, and then your charging. The only thing the Pixel stand adds to this is a little Google Assistant in the bottom right now. So everything else is basically the same. So there may be a mode to switch that back and forth if you like the current version, but right now that's what it's going to look like in the future. Another thing you may notice is on the home screen, the gesture navigation bar that was at the bottom is no longer there when you're just on the home screen. If I swipe up and go into the app drawer, you'll see the little line is back and it just lets you know that you can swipe up or around to use that. Now the gestures have been improved quite a bit, and keep in mind, if you don't like the gestures, you can just simply turn them off and use the back buttons. And I'll show you that later because there's some tweaks to the settings of the gestures as well. Now the actual gesture when you swipe up here has changed a little bit. It feels more refined and more natural. Can swipe up and hold a little bit to get to the app switcher here, go down, go back up, and it just feels fast and fluid no matter what you're doing. So it's really nice. I think they've really refined it. And of course, like I said, you can change that if you hate the gestures and want to use something different. But if you love the gestures, of course, you can just keep them on. Now, another change to the UI, if you press and hold the power button, you'll see the emergency button is a little bit different. Now, I have these buttons on the bottom because of a tweak that I did earlier with the actual terminal commands or command prompt, depending on which device you're using to change it. You can change some of the settings and put it down here. I don't know if that's going to be a setting you can toggle later on, but that's what it looks like for now. But the emergency icon is a little bit different. So it's a new icon, and I don't know that they needed to change that, but it looks different now. They've also changed the night sight UI. So if you go into the camera and go to night sight, you've got a little moon there. The interface is a little bit nicer. You've got your typical buttons for autofocus, near, far, and then you have a little timer as well. So night sight looks a little bit different. I think it's really nice. Just a little bit of a refinement to that UI. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the settings where they've tweaked some other things. Now, if we go into system down here at the bottom, then we go into gestures, and then under gestures, if we go to system navigation, you'll see there's a little icon here and we can actually adjust the back sensitivity. So we're using that back gesture. It says higher sensitivity may conflict with any app gestures along the edge of the screen. So you can change this low to high. This is where it was set by default when I took a look at it to begin with. So swipe back and you're in. So if I want to change that again, maybe change it to high, you have to really swipe to get it to work. So it's just a little tweak that they've added and should help if you like that. And again, this is where I said you can change it to the three button navigation at the bottom if you want, or go back to the gesture navigation. It's just up to you. So we'll go back to settings. Then if we go back to the main page and then go to about phone, if we scroll down, we have Android version. If we tap on Android version, we now have Google Play system update. And this is just a little bit different. Prior to this, it had the name of mainline module version. So they've just changed it to Google Play system update, a little bit of a refinement again. And as far as all of the changes, that's really it. There's not a whole lot of different changes to the UI or anything. Now, there's some known issues as well. Under the notes, there's some apps that may not work properly, including some Google apps. And one of the things that may not work is in settings. So if we go back to settings and we go to the search settings at the top and we want to search for, let's say, gestures. Instead of showing gestures, it may show the word null instead. So that's just something that they note. There's also some issues with web view applications not working properly. And then also with managed devices that use NFC tags not working properly. And also if you're using Android emulator and the Windows hypervisor platform, you could have issues with that as well. Now the Google issues that they're having as far as their apps are concerned has to do with a bunch of different little things. So for example, if we go into the Play Store here, when you go into the Play Store, the screen may flash if you're writing a review. So if you're writing a review on one of these apps, the screen could flash. Also, if you go into the search bar down here on the bottom on the home screen, the search bar, if it's on dark mode and you type in here and you have white text turned on, it may just show a white background. So it may not show you the text, even though it's actually there. Also, if you're using Google Translate, under Google Translate, the tap to translate function apparently isn't working. So that's not working properly on Android Q Beta 6. And then also Chrome may have corrupted videos. So if you're trying to use videos in Chrome, it may have an issue. And then also the first time you open the Google Play Store, it may give you an update dialogue for the first time when it's launched. So those are all the little bugs. There may be some apps that aren't working that you use regularly, but that's everything in Android Q Beta 6. If I find anything major, of course, I'll let you know. And so far, performance seems okay. If you noticed when I closed that last app, Google Play here, there was a little bit of a animation lag. So sometimes it's fast, sometimes it's not. But overall, it's nice. I actually like the gestures. They're very playful and easy to use, and they seem really refined this time around. So performance should be good overall. Battery life has actually been really good for me on Beta 5, so I expect the same with Beta 6. And overall, I would recommend trying it out if you don't have accessibility issues that you need to use regularly. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see more of these videos as soon as they're released. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.